Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of my Craftopia Beginner's Playthrough. I've been looking everywhere, been skipped a lot to find the Executioner. Finally found one, so going after him. This should be my last boss that I need. So I'm going to go in here, defeat him 10 times, and get this aim for a higher goal completed. It's been a long time coming. I'm getting some good hits on him already. That did not take long at all. The Executioner is, to me, is really one of the easier bosses. He's hard to find, but I think that he's one of the easier ones to beat. He has a very distinct fight pattern. His HP doesn't seem like it's that high, so he seems like he's a little bit easier. He definitely doesn't have much magic resistance, so if you're doing a magic build, you're gonna wipe him out pretty quick. I've only got 3 dashboards, so this isn't gonna work as well as I would hope it would, but I'm gonna make it work without having to use any more of my scrolls, because I was getting low on scrolls. I'm gonna grab these chests real quick though, because they're gonna bother me if they're sitting up here. Lots of food, Slate of Evolution. Alright, so let's go back here. We'll do a triangle, if you will, around the platform. And maybe that'll still go pretty quick. Usually 4 of them's best, but you know, whatever works. Make sure you buff. Make sure you make him mad with a little freezing. I'm not hitting him in his weak spot, and he just nailed me. He's got good inside attacks, but yeah, usually if you can keep range, you're not gonna have much trouble with him. And I don't know if anybody noticed, but this is 0.3.70 version, so this is post boss rush dungeon update, and things are looking much better and running much smoother after this update. This new team they have, I don't know if they include some optimization or if it was some optimization from PC that carried over, but on my Series X, this is running fantastic. Even on islands, oh my goodness, that was so quick. even on islands where I've got a lot of automations going, the game is running well. And it's actually surprising how well it's running. So kudos to the development team. Love to see that. Love to see, you know, this game getting better. I have not played it on, I have a Xbox One S, an older, the white one. I haven't tried playing it on there. I think I may have to play just to get a comparison to see if they, any of these improvements have carried over to the older consoles. You know, I feel sorry for those on the older consoles, because it just plays so much better on newer consoles. I mean, really all games do, just because they're more powerful. I just wish they had a solution that they could support everybody. I mean, I know they've got cloud gaming, but that's, as well as that works, that's still not a solution for everybody. going, getting mad. There we go, already halfway there. This is going quick. Love it. Of course, I'm level 59 now and have all my skill buffs, so I need a respec, so I think there's, if I'm gonna go after bosses, I have to drop meteor and spend those 5 points somewhere else, because the meteor storm does me no good inside the dungeons. Didn't even have life siphon on. That boosts you also. Although life siphon can have some bad side effects if you don't have enough life. Because it's funny that when you have life siphon on, it uses your life instead of mana. And if you're low on life and try to cast a heal spell, you will not cast the heal spell and you will die. You have to eat food to get your health back in those situations, and it's not fun. So that's kind of one of the negatives about using that spell or that skill. Look at it go. Too bad that frozen. Come on, unthaw. Not sure why that color changed like that. I didn't really move. It's like the lighting changes or something. It's kind of weird. Dashboards. I need to go find another trader that has a bunch of dashboards, because I am out. I used them all up for my stray mono trap. 7,000. Wow. I must be doing something to get in that 7,000 range. There's another one. Two more to go. But we will have max level. Curious if they'll ever increase it again if they do another update. I mean, they got room. They could do an aim for higher goal and another one and have you beat the sandworm, Fafnir. They could make it a little tricky, maybe beat the boss rush dungeon. I don't know. I think they could do some different things there. Criticals. Number 9. You're a little stuck there, dude. Alright, one more to go. We will have this wrapped up. Really missing that last dashboard. And there you have it. Aim for higher goal 1. Got my level cap increased. So I am maxed out on the level I can go. I can get to 60, which won't take me long. And then I'll be done with this. Alright, I'm going to pick up these dashboards. And then I'm probably going to transition so you don't have to watch it. But my next goal is to go back after the sandworm and farm him to try to get the blueprints I need. So I'm gonna finish out this dungeon, and then you will see a slight transition, and then hopefully I will be fighting a sandworm and getting the blueprints that I need to do my rosaries, because that's what I need to go back into boss rush dungeons to have enough firepower to make it anywhere. Okay, so I've already fought the sandworm once, so I'm going to jump back down here, respawn him, and just start fighting him until he drops the rosary. Hopefully it won't take very long. I believe it's like a 10% chance that he drops rosary blueprints. So theoretically you should have to fight him 10 times to get it. But the problem is that's a 10% chance per blueprint, and there's a light and a dark, so he could drop a light one in his 10% chance, and then I would never get the dark one for another 10. Hopefully it won't take that long. He is kind of finicky. Sometimes I have really good luck. If I can get all my buffs going, it goes pretty quick. That was a nice hit there on his tail. But when you're fighting the sandworm, go for the weak spots on the side and inside his mouth. The sides are best because if you hit the inside of his mouth, he usually spews the acid back on you and it messes you up bad. It can take down your health real quick, just like you saw there. So I always say go for the sides, get back and hit him from a distance, or use Frost Mine if you've got that buffed all the way up. And when he does this, it's always best just to let him hit you. It doesn't do much damage, and he stops doing it. So it's usually a quicker than just keep dodging, just waste stamina. Just let him hit you. It doesn't do very much damage to you at all, unless you just basically have negative defense going, which could possibly happen. And he's frozen, but that's a bad spot for him to be frozen. And he just like appears out of nowhere. Going a little different with some miasma. I've never done miasma on him, but it's actually working pretty well. I'm getting his weak spots, but this is going to spew all over me. And he's dead now. It's hard to tell sometimes when he does his dying animation. It takes forever. And when you hit his weak spots and burst them, he will drop items, and the blueprints can come out of that. So make sure you run around and check for loose items. You know, after each battle, just so there's not a chance that they despawn. It usually takes a long time for those to despawn, or you have to have a lot of items on the field. But just to be on the safe side, just kind of run around and look. Because you could waste another battle that you didn't want to do. Waiting for my skills to come back off cooldown. He always spawns in inopportune places. There you go. See, you gotta get him frozen, then you hit him if he has his mouth open. Short work there. Looks like you dropped a rare metal. I don't really see anything else. Oh, there's something else there. Oh, it looks like it could be a blueprint. And it's a light rosary, which is not what I'm looking for. Oh, bother. Need a dark rosary. Getting some good fragments though, because you'll need the fragments to make a cross, and then you'll need the crosses to make a rosary. It's a multi-step process. It is pretty tedious to have to do this, but it's worth it. Those rosaries are definitely worth it for your attack or magic attack if you're going to do it. That base 250 you get on those on attacker. Magic attack is definitely worth the every point you get there. I don't know if you can get criticals on the tail part. Might be able to. Oh! Hitting with one of those little meteor things. Not able to hit that as is. That felt like those should have hit me, but it didn't. Explosions. I'm trying to rebuff him though this fight while he's underground. I'm not sure what just happened to the sandworm. I guess it's frozen? I don't know. I'm not sure what is happening. Now he's gonna do this thing. Whack-a-mole. Get up, then I'm gonna hit your weak spot. Yeah, I get some critical on you. Not feeling good. Shot there. Oh, he almost ate me. That would have been bad. Oh, what? That was cool. He's kinda. Hop back up. Ooh, Meteor Strike works pretty good. It hits all its criticals. Once again, I'm going to do a little different with this Miasma. I'm kind of liking it, but also not liking it. Not sure what was up with his mouth there. Not the best loot. Get her buffs on. Get eight up. And respawn. I'm getting better at this remembering. That's not good in that spot. There we go. Well, that started out good. Got some good hits in his mouth. Yeah, 6,000-7,000 there. So now, boy, should be able to shoot those things. And he's dying. Look out. It'd be nice to get some Terraborn leather, but just got worms. Just worms. And he spawned right under me. Awesome. Get it. That is not doing much damage there. But I think I saw maybe a blueprint fall out. Yep. See a blueprint. Maybe this is the one. That did not count. I think you should be able to stand on the rocks and he shouldn't be able to hit you. Very much like in the movies. That's what they always do. They get in the rocks and they can only get you if they're in the sand. In Dune, that's what they did, isn't it? They crawl up in the rocks to get away from the sandworms. I think they did the same thing in Tremors, in fact. They'd get on a vehicle or do something like that. See, I was on that rock. You should not be able to get me. Oh. Let's get criticals on that frost mine. Just worms, bone. Disappointing. Got a lot of stuff over here. I guess it's some casualties of war. Pico jazz and foxes that I took out while I was trying to kill a sandworm. So I quit spawning over here, guys. What is up with that glow? Must be a luring type mob up there that's got a red glow. It's a cool effect, but it just looks weird. This lighting is just off. Doing good, doing good, doing good. Come on, come on, come on, pop up. Give me some chances of critical. trick there, but he still didn't come out. There he goes. Oh, did some nice damage on that. That was sick. Lots of rare metal, obsidian, but no rosaries. Alright, had to skip through some battles. I'm sure y'all are tired of me seeing me beat this sand eater worm multiple times. Lots of good hits on that one. Sorry, Pico J, you get in the wrong path. Dying. He just came out to die. I got plenty of blueprints of the Light Rosary. Still no Dark Rosary, though. As soon as I get it, this episode will be over. I promise. Get it right in the kisser. And just get it done. Nice. That's not doing anything. Got a weak spot. In the mouth. In the mouth. Puke. Look out. Oh. Do it. Don't want to get stuck on that. And he knocked me right into it. That's why I was trying to avoid that. He's almost there. Almost dead. Got that one bursted. Ah, no way, he was dead. That's what you get for turning your back to me. Ah, yes, there it is. All right, everybody, I got my blueprint I was looking for. Thanks for watching.